Hello guys, we are here to discuss jumping caterpillar question, and so let's head towards the question. So here we know that there are n leaves numbered from 1 to n. A caterpillar at leaf 1 and it jumps from leaf to leaf in the multiples of aj. So we know that aj can be any number like 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5. So now we have to find out that from how many leaves from 1 to n are left uneaten out of all the k caterpillars. K is an integer number here, like it can be 1, 2, 3, 4 caterpillars, and so we have to just find out basically that how many leaves remain uneaten. So let's head to the problem. We have to take the inputs. The first input is integer t, which denotes the number of test cases. Later we have two other inputs which we have to take from the user, which is n, which denotes the number of leaves, and k, which denotes the number of the caterpillars. Later we also have to take the input of the factors, like the jumping factors of the caterpillars. So basically you can see an example. The example here shows 1, which indicates the test case is 1. Later we see 10. 10 indicates there are 10 leaves. 3 indicates there are 3 caterpillars, and 2, 3 and 5 indicate there are the jumping factors of the caterpillars are in the order 2, 3 and 5. So yeah, the caterpillar which is with the jumping factor 2 will eat the leaves 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10, and the second caterpillar which has the jumping factor of 3 will eat the leaves later numbered 3, 6 and 9, and the third caterpillar which has the jumping factor of 5 will eat the leaves 5 and 10. So ultimately the leaves which are uneaten are 1 and 7, and hence their number is 2. So yeah, the program expects us to show the number of uneaten leaves. So here I am with my program, and let's head to it. Here, so we just start off with taking the input of the test cases from the user. So let's say the user gives it 3. So the whole program will continue 3 times, as you can see. So the program continues while there is a 0 input here, because when we get a 0 here, the while will get a false statement, and hence the program will just exit out. Okay, and now we take the k, which indicates the number of leaves from the user. Later we have n, which indicates the number of caterpillars, and we have to take this input from the user. And later we have this step which decrement, like you have here. So yeah, basically we are doing this here. As you can see, it's like t equal to t minus 1. So every time we run the program, the test case will be reduced by 1. So like we have 3, so it will give 3, 2 and 1, which shows that when we have a 0, it will be run, till that time it should run 3 times. Later we take a list b for writing the factors, the jumping factors. We have a to input the jumping factors, and then we append it to the code, writing b dot append, and just after we write b dot append, the jumping factors go into the list. So now we have seen all the ways to take the input for the list, and also the two variables, and as well as the test case. So now we head on straight to the computational part. For computing the program, we take a variable f. So now just saying f represents the number of leaves which are eaten by the caterpillar. So keep this in mind that we have f, which is the number of leaves which are eaten by the caterpillar. So now we make a loop from I equal to 0 to n to I equal to k. And what was k? K was the number of leaves. So we take I from 0 to k, and with that we have a nested loop for j in range 0 to n. N is the number of the caterpillars. So let us consider the example which we had seen previously. We have the test case 1, and we have 10 leaves and 3 caterpillars with their jumping factors 2, 3 and 5. So we have n, which is the number of caterpillars, and the number of leaves. So now we continue. for the two for loops, let us say we go in the first loop and then we have I value as 1. Later on the second loop, we have the j value as 2. So now, because j, if I is 1 mod 2 will not be equal to 0, and hence we do not run this loop. Now we increment j, so I mod 2 and now 3 will not be equal to 0. So we check I mod 2, I mod 3 and I mod 5. So in each of the case we do not get a 0, and hence now we increment I. So after we increment I, we go I equal to 2. Now in this we go I mod like 2 mod 2, which is equal to the 0, and hence we increment f and we break out of the loop. So now listen, if you go from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just leaving the number 1 and 7, we will have an incrementation in f value every time. So only we will have two f values where the f value will not be incremented. I mean, we'll only have two I values where f will not be incremented. So we will now have f value given as 8. So 10 minus 8 is 2, and hence we'll have 2 uneaten leaves at the end of this program. So let's just have a look at whether it's running properly. So we have number of test cases is 1, number of leaves we consider 10, the number of caterpillars are 3, the jumping factors 2, 3 and 5. So yeah, our program runs very perfectly. The number of leaves which are uneaten are 2. So thank you so much guys, I hope you have understand the program very well. So take a note of this program, yeah, and make sure to hit the like and subscribe button if you have enjoyed it. Thank you.